Nagaland. There are a lot of tribes and festivals in this state. Don't worry, Hornbill Festival is there to the rescue.
Nagaland shares border with Assam in the west, Arunachal Pradesh and Assam in the north, Myanmar in the east, and Manipur in the south. Now let's see some primary details about Nagaland. Nagaland is inhabited by 16 officially recognized tribes. Each tribe is unique in character with its own distinct customs, languages, and dressing. There are also many sub-tribes. What is common among them is language and religion. Nagaland is one of the 3 states in India with Christianity as major religion. Nagaland is the only predominantly Baptist state in the world with 75% of population. Catholics are also found here. Nagaland has special provisions under Article 371 of Indian Constitution. It is to protect Naga culture. Actually, other than Nagaland, 10 other Indian states also have special provisions under Article 371. The word Naga is said to have originated from Burmese word Naka, means people with earrings. This is in fact an umbrella term used for Indo-Mangaloid people living in this region. Dimapur is the largest city and commercial capital. As other northeastern states, you need inner line permit to enter Nagaland except for Dimapur. Like in Mizoram, Jhum cultivation is practiced here. Mount Saramadi is the highest peak in Nagaland. The state is mostly mountainous except those areas bordering Assam Valley, which comprise 9% of the total area of the state. Nagaland is called the falcon capital of the world. You can see Amur falcons here. The bird is not really endemic to Nagaland, but they come here annually before they make their way to southern Africa. Like in Manipur, there is a Second World War cemetery and a war museum in honor of those who lost their lives during Second World War during the fight between British Indian and Japanese troops. Many of those who were lost their lives were Naga people, particularly of Angami tribe. The state is mostly hilly and the mountain ranges form a natural barrier to Myanmar. Nagaland is called as the land of festivals. Each tribe have their own specific festivals. Hornbill festival is the most popular annual event of Nagaland. Actually, it is an umbrella festival. This is a sort of parent festival which portrays the glimpse of festivals of all different tribes. This festival was started in the year 2000 by state government to promote tourism and to promulgate the tribal culture of the state. 80% of the people are involved in agriculture, but Naga people loves meat than veggies. Some of the tribes eat dog meat. It is just a cultural act of Nagas that has been practiced for ages. Literacy rate in Nagaland is 80.11%, higher than the national average. Nagaland is a dry state, which means you cannot get alcohol here except these 4: whiskey, rum, beer, and Indian-made foreign liquor. Every tribe is unique, so as their language. This means that these tribes' languages are unintelligible. This led to the formation of what we know as Nagamese Creole. It is a common language meant for communication created with Assamese as the base. It has its origin from the interaction of the hill Naga people with the indigenous Assamese people in the plain and developed primarily as a market language to communicate for trade. Despite the fact that Nagamese Creole is actually there for communication, English is used for education and other official purposes. Nagaland is the only state in India which shows decline in population. Hoot Jolokia or ghost pepper was once world's hottest chili. Angami tribe's stone pulling ceremony is something which you have to see. The stone pulling ceremony is the main attraction of the third day of Hornbill festival, as around 6,000 Angami men pull a stone a distance of around 4 km. Dressed in traditional attires, woman walks in the front extending moral support to the man. Naga Hoho is the apex tribal body of Nagas. In Mavo market in Kohima, you can get not only vegetables or meat, but also things like frogs, snails, worms, etc. Longwa is an Indian village where its citizens has dual citizenships of India and Myanmar. Finally, one more thing. Seeing these photos, don't misunderstand that people in Northeast wear tribal dresses every time. Actually, there are a lot of misunderstanding about Northeast in India itself. They dress like other Indians, like shirt or pants or other comfortable dresses. They only dress like this during their festivals. Actually, they are very educated than many other Indian states. Also, Northeastern region is very rich in history and natural resources.
So that's all about Nagaland, and if I made any mistake, let me know it by your comments, and if you know anything more about this state, please comment that as well and make this video resourceful. Thank you.